everyone. I'm Dan Philgreen.
And I'm Rochelle Chernowski. This is Shell Point Today for Thursday, October 16th. On today's show, now that the Pavilion Auxiliary's Bakeless Bake Sale is complete, find out more about what your donations will do. Plus, resident Ruth Deuber takes us inside her kitchen to show us what's cooking. And
'tis the season, only 10 weeks until Christmas. Employee Christmas Fund Committee Chairman Dick Wright will let you know how you can show your appreciation to the great people that work here at Shell Point by donating to the employee Christmas gift.
But first, we're all too familiar with the clouds here in Southwest Florida. Every afternoon in the summer, they bring us plenty of rain. How can we store computer information in a cloud? Well, rain clouds are not the answer, and if you're a little confused about cloud computing, get your questions answered by Mike Peterson from Computer Medics. He'll be conducting a seminar today to clear your mind of any confusion. The discussion will get underway today at 2:15 in the Manatee Room on the island.
And one of the most recent programs to be added for you here at Shell Point is the Day Respite Program at the Arbor. This program offers structured daily activities along with supervised care and companionship for your loved ones, giving you a needed break from providing them care. And you can learn more about this program at their open house tomorrow at 10 a.m. in the Arbor Community Room at the Woodlands.
As you know, Shell Point has many ways in which you can give back and embrace the community and social dimension of your life quest. And perhaps one of the best and most popular ways is by volunteering with the Pavilion Auxiliary.
Hundreds of residents are involved with the Auxiliary and its many committees, including the one Terry Colath is talking about, the Mail Committee.
Hi, I'm Terry Colath, and I'm here speaking with Joan Morgan in the Auxiliary Room in the Larson Pavilion on the island at Shell Point. And Joan is our chairman of our Mail Committee. Thanks for joining me, Joan.
You're welcome. Good to be here.
Now, we would like to share with Shell Point, first of all, the fact that we have this amazing committee and the mail gets delivered, and a little bit about how that happens. You're chairperson. How long have you been chairing this committee?
I've been the chairman for 5 years. And this committee, the purpose, of course, is to get mail to our residents every day. One of the things that is the nicest for them is when they get a personal card or something else in the mail, and we bring that to them. The sorters are here every day in the morning, approximately around 9:30, and they sort the mail, and shortly after that, the deliverer comes in. And the deliverer is the person that not only brings the mail to the individual resident, but the person that comes to greet them. So that's what we do with both of those jobs.
So as always, the Auxiliary does a specific service, but they bring a lot more to the resident.
That's right.
Now I'm speaking with Marilyn Brownwell of Royal Bonnet. And Marilyn is what we call a sorter. What does it mean to sort the mail? There must be mountains of it, Marilyn.
I separate the large mail, like the magazines and so forth, and find the residents. I put the numbers on there and put them in the cart. And then with the other mail, first of all, I take out anything that is first class mail because that has to be listed in a book. And the other mail, I just put the room numbers on them. And in the cart, I put them in the cart according to which floor they're on. It's only a couple of hours, really.
A couple of hours every Wednesday you put in to make sure this mail goes where it's supposed to.
Hopefully.
That's wonderful. Now I'm talking with Warren Atkinson of Parkwood, and he is what we call a mail deliverer. Hi, Warren.
Hi, how are you?
Good. How long have you been delivering mail at Shell Point?
About 5 years.
5 years, so you know how to do it.
Oh, yeah. Well, I delivered mail for 38.
Really?
And when Joan played Mahjong with my wife, she said, I need somebody to deliver the mail. That's all I got here.
That's fabulous. So we have had a very experienced mail deliverer.
Very interesting.
I bet it is. So you come into this auxiliary room. You pick up the cart that the sorters have gotten all ready for you.
Correct.
And what do you do?
I go out and I do the first, second, third, and fourth floor.
In order?
In order.
So right. People kind of are ready to expect you at certain times.
Well, the second floor, we just give it to the desk because they don't want us
Sure.
In with the people, you know, so, which is fine.
Sure. And so first of all, you actually go into people's homes, knock on the door and say, mail?
Yes, yes, yes.
Nice.
Yeah.
And there are friends and neighbors who are doing rehab. It could be anybody that you'll be walking into, right?
Well, you know what's nice about it? Some of them don't see anybody. They have nobody coming in. And when you say, I have a mail for you or a letter for you, they light up, you know, just like that, you know. So it's what makes it interesting.
Kind of like Santa Claus.
Ask, you know, they ask, well, how's the weather out there? And some of them don't say anything.
Yeah. Thank you so much for what you do.
Yeah.
Well, Joan, it's been wonderful getting to know a couple of your volunteers, getting to know a little bit more about Joan Morgan, the person who runs the whole thing, and to also get a feel for how well this operation works. And if we are here in the pavilion recuperating, or if we live in this building, we know that not only is our mail going to come to us, but it's going to come from some pretty nice people.
You're right about that.
Thank you.
Thanks, Terry. That's a terrific service for the residents of the Larson Pavilion.
Now it's time to find out what's cooking.
Well, today, resident Ruth Deuber takes us on a trip to the Hawaiian Islands for a delicious and tropical dish that's sure to please.
Hello, I'm Ruth Deuber, and this really is what's cooking at Shell Point. However, I don't have my normal apron on, the red one, but I do have a daughter here. This is my next to the youngest, and we have sibling rivalry going on because our son Tom has been on, and Jane was on a couple weeks ago, and now we have Sue.
My turn.
That's your turn, yeah. And Sue is from Hawaii. You want to tell a little bit how long you've lived there?
Well, lived there over 30 years. Never really thought I would end up staying there, but Hawaii is a hard place to move from. We like the outdoors and a lot of the vegetation, very similar to what you have here at Sanibel. But yeah, it's a beautiful place to live and not a bad place. When you go on vacation and you like to go home, then you know that.
All right, but it's hard to find a place to go.
And it's so far away.
Well, it is so far away. I know we don't get to see each other very often. But you are going to make something, I think, very tropical and very good. And I'm going to let her get started with your salsa. And we're going to put the salsa on top of tilapia. So I'm going to go ahead and get the fish ready while she's starting with this. Okay, it's all yours.
Good. So this is a very fresh salsa that is popular in a lot of the fine restaurants in Hawaii. You can do this on top of grilled fish or chicken. Today we're going to, like Mom said, we're going to saute some tilapia. We like to use mahi-mahi. I noticed you had some at your Publix. So whatever fresh fish you like. And it's basically a topping, a salsa that can be used not only to top fish or chicken. I've even been known to put that on a baked potato.
Oh my goodness,
so today we're going to actually use pineapple for the salsa, but I have a beautiful mango tree at home that at certain seasons has dropped 50 mangoes a day.
So that's why I get the calls from you, Mom. What else can I do with mangoes?
Right.
This is the fish we're going to use today. It's tilapia. And I've cut it into smaller portions so it doesn't take as long to cook. And actually, I'm going to use salt and pepper, and then dip it in egg, and then panko crumbs. Okay, go ahead, Sue.
Alrighty, so we're going to, like I said, this is a tropical salsa. The ingredients, we have pineapple, which is kind of the star of our show today. You can see this cute little decoration we've made out of the pineapple top, kind of a nice impromptu thing for a party. We have some chopped yellow pepper, cilantro. Now, of course, any of these ingredients you can do more or less of based on your own preference. Tomatoes, which is kind of the staple of almost any salsa. And then we have some sweet onion that we have also chopped finely here. And then last but not least, we're going to dress it with just a little bit of the lemon juice to kind of keep it moist. Our pepper. This is a jalapeno pepper, fresh from Publix. This is the only thing I have left to chop here. And you know, when you're working with peppers, of course, I've cut this in half and removed the seeds. It's actually the seeds that are the hottest part. And make sure when you're working with any pepper that you wash your hands real well when you're finished. You don't want to rub your eyes or... We're just this. You can also use the jalapenos that you find in a jar, the kind that you might serve on a nacho. And then we're going to mix everything together. So we are ready to assemble our salsa. The tomatoes, I like to use a tomato that is a bit firm. You don't want them mushy. Of course, you really, the best part of the tomato is the firm part. So you can actually leave some of those seeds. And the nice thing about this too is that it's just a beautiful color. Very, very flavorful, very fresh. And again, it's a salsa, so whatever's left, you know, can be used even just to dip chips in for a party. Or we have mango salsa. When mango is in season, my family will go through a large bowl of mango salsa in one football game, so it's a favorite. I'm not going to add quite as much onion. This can be modified to suit your own taste, but you can see we've got nice color going. And we'll add our little bit of spice here. Now, I would ordinarily add a little more than that because my family likes a little more heat. And some salsas will call for a vinegar. I like just a plain, fresh lemon juice is what I have found. And believe it or not, this is just one lemon here. So we got a very juicy lemon. I'm gonna add about half and let's see how we're doing. You don't want it
You
want
to tell them the secret I told you about getting the juicy lemon?
Yeah.
I did put the lemon in the microwave for just a few seconds and rolled it around and then put it back in the microwave so it's a little bit warm. And that makes it really juicy. So
there we go. Yeah, new trick. I thought while the salsa is sort of marinating and Mama is fixing the fish that I would show you a little trick. For the outrigger canoe, and you put it in there, and then like to serve that with toothpicks. Oops. And then you can just take your.
Shall I eat it?
Wow.
Is it that good?
That's a really good pineapple for I'm kind of a pineapple snob coming from Hawaii.
I know you are. I was afraid we wouldn't get a good one.
Those are actually very big bites. But
okay, that's okay.
You can cut your outrigger however you want. The kids really enjoy that. This is the breading that we're using on the fish today, and it's called panko. It can be found in the oriental section.
They have it in with the flour now because it's so popular.
Yeah, so it's actually a Japanese breading that's a little bit thicker and flakier than a breadcrumb. It gives the fish a little bit more of a crunch on the outside.
So I added more oil. Turn the pretty side up there. Okay, Sue, you put your salsa on, some in the middle and then on top.
Mm-hmm. All righty. I think what makes this salsa special is it's got the citrus.
Do you want
citrus.
A slotted spoon, maybe? Or are you okay?
I think we're good. We'll use this little scooper. It's the combination of the citrus and the spice and a little bit of onion. And like I say, you can adapt this to your own personal preference. So there we go.
Put some on that one too. Okay. I'm going to have a little bite of fish and some of the salsa. Whoops. Cut that one. It's just perfect. You try it. It's just perfect with the fish.
Good.
It's wonderful.
Just scoop a little. Good thing we have a whole bowl here, huh?
Uh-huh. It's all falling apart, so.
Okay.
Yep. Well, we really like it. I'll put the directions for everything up on the website, and we hope you'll try it. And thank you for doing it with me, Sue.
Sure.
Bye-bye. Aloha.
With some of the cooler temperatures we've experienced this month and the influx of people we're seeing here at Shell Point, that must mean the holidays are getting closer.
And with the holidays near, you'll want to make sure you remember the folks here at Shell Point that work hard every day to make the community as wonderful as it is. That's why you'll want to be a part of the employee Christmas gift.
And here to tell you more about how you can take part is Dick Wright, chairman of the Employee Christmas Fund Committee.
Thank you for having me here today to talk about the Shell Point Employees Christmas Gift. It's really very important to the residents and to the employees. Imagine the difference cash can make if you years ago got some cash 1 week before Christmas. It's a big deal, and you can ask any one of the employees. Please do, just ask them, and you'll be really surprised how much they appreciate this and how important it is to them. And so far, we're very pleased with the response we're getting. The last day to give is Friday, December 5th. So put that on your calendar. Of course, you can give today or tomorrow. You don't have to wait till December 5th, but that's the last day. You know, this gift is our only tangible way to show our appreciation to the employees. They work for us all year long, 365 days, and we do not tip them because they can't accept tips and they can't accept gifts. Just think what they can do for us, what they do for us. They clean, they repair sidewalks and streets, they clean our bathrooms, they clean our kitchens, they work for us. They cut grass, they trim the bushes, they paint. They do windows. No one does windows. They do. They cook in the restaurants. They wash the pots and pans. They deliver the prescriptions right to our door. They keep our medical records and our appointments, medical appointments. At the pavilion, they do laundry. They change the beds. They take care of our clothing. They feed those that need feeding, push wheelchairs. And the employees here answer any question you may have at courtesy desk or at that number that does all, 454-2190. Just call with any question 24 hours a day, and they'll answer it for you and help you. They set up meeting rooms for us for all activities. For the shows and the major entertainment, they do the photos, they write articles for magazines such as Shell Point Life, papers such as the Weekly Reminder, and, of course, our own TV station right here. They drive us places where our engineers, electricians, mechanics, warehouse men. I can go on and on. Imagine we have 1,000 dedicated employees smiling at us all the time, 365 days a year. They're here to help us cope. Anything we need, we just ask. And once a year, everyone can give back to them. You can give back to them once a year. The smiles of Shell Point are something that is important to us all. It's an atmosphere that they develop here. Mostly the employees do, where they're smiling at us and waving at us and thanking us all the time. I've been to organizations or living situations like this in other areas and other states where they don't do that. And it's really a different atmosphere that you wouldn't want to live in. So if you've already given to the Christmas Fund for the employees, thank you very much. If you have not yet given, please consider things like toys, clothes, and Christmas trees, etc. Cost more than they ever did. Thank you for your generosity, and it is greatly appreciated by the employees. And it's nice to give. Thank you.
That's certainly something that many residents will want to be a part of this holiday season.
And now it's time to cover all of today's happenings, Academy News, Menus, and Village Church Connections.
Hi, I'm Jill Aldrink, and I'm here with Bev Chanley, and we're going to tell you what's happening today at Shell Point. We start the morning at 7:15 with the Health Connections Bend, Breathe, and Balance. They meet in the Health Club. At 8 o'clock, the Men's Golf Association meets out at the golf course. Also at 8 o'clock is the Round Robin Doubles Tennis at the tennis courts in the Woodlands. And the Paddlers Club gathers at the kayak storage area at 8:30. At 9 o'clock, you can participate in the Operation Christmas Child Shoebox Assembly. That will take place at the Village Church. And at 9:15, shuffleboard out at the shuffleboard courts. Current Events meets in the game room at the Woodlands at 9:30. Also at 9:30, we have the Ladies Match Play Tennis at the tennis courts. And Samba, the card game, in the Sable Room at the Woodlands. We move on to 9:45 with Introduction to Beginning Line Dancing in the Health Club. The Susie Q heads out to the Matanzas Inn for lunch at 10 o'clock. And at 10:15, the basic line dancing takes place in the Health Club on the island. The poetry group will be meeting in the Tarpon Room at 10:15, and that is our final activity for the morning. Here's Bev to tell you what's happening this afternoon.
Well, folks, we're going to start out at 12:45 with Mahjong. That's played in the library lounge on the island. 1:15, the Butterfly Garden Committee meeting will be a meeting at the Butterfly Garden. Also at 1:15, we have the Spot Play Readers. That stands for Shell Point's own theater in the Osprey Room. At 1:30, we have a Health Connections class, Aqua Pilates Stretch. That's held at the LifeQuest Aquatic Center. At 2:15, we have the Computer Club meeting in the Manatee Room. The Christmas Cantata rehearsal will be in the choir room at the church at 2:30. 2:45 is the time for Health Connection class, Balance and Mobility Training Level 2. That's in the Health Club and currently closed. At 4 o'clock, you'll find our seamstress here for her weekly visit. She'll be in the Osprey Room on the island. At 4:30, the Alcoholics Anonymous meeting will be in the Sable Room at the Woodlands. And we'll jump to 6:30 for Pinnacle in the Library Lounge on the island. Our last activity for the day is at 7 o'clock, and it is the Trailblazers Bible Study Group. They'll be in the game room of the Woodlands. Well, we wish you a very best day today, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.
Hi, I'm Terry Coleth with your Academy information for Thursday, October 16th. At 7:15 a.m., court pickup begins on the island for Academy on the Go. Discover scenic Mount Dora for those who have signed up. And at 1 o'clock, Mahjong Basics continues in the second floor country kitchen at the Arbor. At 1:30, we have an iPad class, What's in the Air, continuing in the Oak Room at the Woodlands.
Menus for Thursday. In the Crystal Room, the Crystal Platter is barbecue chicken with roasted potatoes and carrots. The dinner special is the Crystal Carving Board for $13.95, and the soup of the day is lentil. In the Island Cafe for lunch, the special is a grilled ham and cheese panini with chips for $7.25. The dinner special is Thai night for $8.25. Dinner specials in the Palm Grill are grilled New York strip for $18.95 or baby back ribs for $13.95. All menus are available 24 hours a day at www.shellpoint.net.
It's a joy to welcome you today to Village Church Connections. I'm here with our international worker in residence, Janice Quinlan. Welcome, Janice.
Thank you, Glenda.
Janice, you have not been at Shell Point for Operation Christmas Child before.
Right.
But every year we engage with Operation Christmas Child. We pack shoe boxes, we bring them to the Village Church, and we send them off around the world. And this year our goal is 400 boxes.
Wow.
So we're hoping between the Shell Point community and the members of the Village Church, we can pack a lot of boxes and send them overseas. And I wanted to talk to you about this ministry because I know when you were in Thailand, you saw this ministry happen up close and personal. Tell us a little bit about it.
Okay, well, the boxes come to Thailand and they arrive in Bangkok and they contact the churches and ask if they'd like to participate, if there's someone that could come and pick up the boxes and how many they would like to receive. And in almost every situation, these boxes are used for outreaches in villages and communities. So it's not something that they use within the church, but it's their way to reach out to their community mm-hmm. by having a children's event. And the great joy that these village children have, who almost never get a gift, even on their own birthday, mm-hmm. to receive a box and open the box and find out what was packed for them. If it's joyous for you to pack them, it's twice as much for us to receive them.
As you've observed this happening and taking place and children opening their boxes, do you have any useful hints for us when we're packing a box? What do they like?
Well, one thing that I've noticed is a big hit are caps, baseball caps, those kind of things. Kids seem to like bubbles. That's okay. always fun for almost every age group. Balloons, okay. things that are like toys, or sometimes they like to have a pretty cup that might have a picture of a Barbie doll or cartoons or something that they can use personally in their room or in their house. So really the basics mm-hmm. are the things that children in other cultures like.
I appreciate you sharing that. That just inspires us to begin to think about Operation Christmas Child. Boxes will soon be available at the village church. People can pick them up and take them home, pack them. But now's a good time to just begin to watch for sales and things like that. Our collection dates will happen middle of November, and there'll be quite a bit of promo that'll be out as we approach that time. Thank you, Janice, for sharing that with us. And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to pick up your box and begin to think about packing it for Operation Christmas Child this year. Have a wonderful day.
Yes. We're glad you joined us for today's show. Tune in tomorrow as we discuss a very important event taking place in Fort Myers that could help more than 5 million Americans, including many residents right here at Shell Point.
Until then, this is Shell Point Today for Thursday, October 16th. I'm Dan Filgreen.
And I'm Rochelle Chernowski. For all of us here at Shell Point TV, we hope you have a great day, and we'll see you again tomorrow.